We're live in Gehenna, Texas, at the magnificent HELNL Stadium. Built by zillionaire owner, GM, and coach, Scary Clones. He describes it as a Roman Coliseum, theme park, slaughterhouse, art museum, and secret bordello all in one. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Killadelphia Evils go up against the Malice Hellboys. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with you on MFL Game Day. Hey, Bricks, do you smell something burning?
Thanks for reminding me. I left my rubber foot in the toaster oven to warm it up. Last time I left it there too long, it came out like Saganaki. Opa! It's freezing in here.
Hey, why don't you take a shampoo and ouzo, stick your head in the toaster oven. That'll warm you up.
And it's first and 10. Defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. That pass play was good for 3 yards. Second down and 7. Oh, he just got popped big time.
Oh, my God. I thought his head was going to pop off like a big zit.
First down and 5. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's warming down this guy to the speed feet, Grim. He's running from his demons, it's clear.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, huh?
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Mama, he just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10.
And it... is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again. It just fell off for the third time today. I was barely even chewing on it.
That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be fantastic.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And it's first and 10.
You know, this berserk dirty trick ain't fair to the...
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. He could go all the way. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. A touchdown saving tackle. It's first and 10. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Second down and more than the QB would like. A mix of tiger blood, shark blood, and internet comments. Roid Rage brings out the... Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
Yeah, big deal. Mr. Meat for Brains ran with a ball and didn't fall out.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. It's first and 10. And that's when the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
Third down and 5. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. On that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Second down and 10. They could not connect on that play. Third down and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm the greatest. Greatest, I tell you.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called...
It's good! The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
First and 10. soft balls, he's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Second down in a very lot. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
Second down in a lot.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Third and four. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. Stayed in a hurry. Give him 10 yards right there. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. It's first and 10.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Briggs. Very smart.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First down and 3. When they use their pin, it breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Yeah.
And the ref just called a bullshit penalty. First down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. Missing the pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. And then to first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit. Second down and 2. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. And it's first and 10. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. They stop the clock, but they only have 1 timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have 9.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for...
And that'll be their final timeout. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Second down and 10. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. We're at the start of the third quarter in a nail biter. The teams line up for the second half kickoff.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Second down and 10. Not much there, maybe a yard. Third down and 8. Falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when the receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis as always there, Bricks.
Well, thank you. I do my part.
Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But, and he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go. He's unstoppable.
Bricks, I can't believe the defense didn't stop the run.
Maybe they just wanted more shots at the QB.
Yeah, got a point there. And it's first and 10. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done.
Take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and ten. Second down and long. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. Third down and long. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he's got a chance for a good return here. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. First and ten. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
Nice pickup for 6 yards. Second down and four. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Third down and three.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
First down and one. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkeys getting drafted on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and ten. They called a warp speed dirty prick. He's so fast, he watches 60 minutes and 60 seconds. Second down and a lot. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Third down and the punter is warming up. Bricks, they just made up a whole lot of field in a hurry with that pass play.
And I just made up a new name for a sandwich.
Man, these guys have metal balls. They're going to try to pick up the first down here.
Do they jingle when they run?
They clank, you moron. He said balls, not bells.
Oh, they take it to the air and pick up a fourth down conversion. I thought they were crazy to go for it.
You know, they still might be bricks, but crazy works in the MFL sometimes. Other times, it just comes back with a shotgun.
Baby, I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Second down and more than the QB would like.
He should apply for the Mutant Volleyball League.
Hey, yeah, don't give the fans any ideas. The commish already spends all day on Twitter shooting down rumors. Third down and, well, good luck. Nicely done for a first down. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. And it's first and 10. Pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and 3. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
They want more points, so they're going for 2. And he gets into the end zone for the conversion.
Nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about? Wow.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a car for Wesson home.
And it's first and 10. Picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6. And that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Third down, and the punter is warming up.
And the
that QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy... And he was stuck to him like glue. For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chick.
Boom! And it's first and 10. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. They're back up here on first. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Now, this guy had a lot of integrity. If he took a bribe, he blew the whistle. He put his money where his mouth was.
Yeah, now his mouth is where his foot was, on the ground.
First down in a mile. Roid Rage ignites that deep down violent rage and makes you unstoppable.
I'll take a Roid Rage with a pocket chaser. Make it snappy, will you, Shorty?
And he's off to the races. He's at the 10. And he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run! Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
First and 10. He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10. Oh, mama. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. That's a catch for a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. Here comes the extra point attempt. It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh. It's first and 10. And the quarterback throws a murder ball, which will slice its way through any defensive player trying to block it.
That's really put
the- And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's what you call a killer one-hitter, folks.
I did a killer one-hitter once at an ungrateful undead riot fest. I woke up with three guys gnawing on my kneecap.
And it's first and 10. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And defense burns its last timeout. You can't take them into the locker room, so you might as well use them now.
Why would you want to take a timeout into the locker room, Grim? That doesn't sound right.
Third down and 9. Running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies.
The Malice Hellboys win today's game. That was one hell of a slugfest. That was worth the price of admission, right, guys?
I paid for admission. I expect girls dancing on a pole or something.
Girls playing about a lap dance.
You don't even have a lap, you little freakazoid.
Follow me.
Let's see what the MVP has to say about today's outcome. Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.